The next vitamin I want to talk to you about is super important for your health. This vitamin is essential for the production of your red blood cells and your DNA, and also for the proper functioning of your brain and nervous system. That's really a pretty big job for any vitamin. B12 is up for the challenge. I'm Kim Rose. I'm a registered dietitian nutritionist and a certified nutrition support clinician. I've invited along some experts in the field to provide you with the latest information, not only for yourself, but your family when it comes to what to take and why. I, for one, would love to hear about all the incredible benefits of having enough B12.
Vitamin B12 is a water-soluble nutrient that plays many critical roles in the body. It's needed for energy production, DNA synthesis, and the functioning of nerve cells. It's also necessary for the production of red blood cells. B12 also regulates the amount of homocysteine in your blood. Having elevated levels of homocysteine may increase your risk of heart disease. So, supplementing with B12 may help reduce this risk. Studies suggest that B12 supplementation may help reduce depressive symptoms in people with low normal B12 levels, and may also be used as a helpful tool for relieving stress.
What are the signs of vitamin B12 deficiency?
There are many possible signs and symptoms of vitamin B12 deficiency. One of the first you may notice is glossitis, and that just means that your tongue is inflamed and can become red, swollen, and painful. You might also see other changes, such as canker sores or dry, cracked skin at the corners of your mouth. Some people develop anemia, which can make you feel unusually weak and tired, or you may feel dizzy and short of breath, especially when you're exercising. But neurological symptoms are actually the most common. You may notice numbness and tingling in your hands and feet, or you may feel dizzy and have difficulty walking. If left untreated, vitamin B12 deficiency can cause permanent nerve damage. So if you are experiencing any of these symptoms, don't hesitate to talk to your doctor.
So now you may be asking, how can I get enough B12 into my diet, seeing that the body doesn't make B12 on its own? So there's three different types of ways you can get your B12. You can get it from certain foods, from supplement use, and also by injection. Tracking what you eat can definitely help to make sure you're getting enough B12 in your body. Let me share with you a few items to put in your shopping cart. Organ meat like liver or kidneys from veal, lamb, or beef, steak, clams, sardines, tuna, trout, salmon are all good sources. For the vegetarian or vegan crowd, fortified cereals can work well with your dietary preference. If you eat a varied, healthy diet, preventing a vitamin B12 deficiency can be fairly simple. If you struggle to get it into your diet or your body cannot simply absorb enough vitamin B12, getting a supplement can be a simple way to boost your levels.